Migrating your business email away from GoDaddy can seem daunting. At first glance, there doesn't appear to be a way to export your inbox. So what do you do? In this video, I'll show you step by step how to migrate your email away from GoDaddy so you can save some money and say goodbye to GoDaddy for good. I'll be showing you how to migrate your Microsoft hosted email that you purchased through GoDaddy to Porkbun's email hosting. While Porkbun is who I'm showcasing in this video, the same general concepts apply when it comes to migrating your GoDaddy inbox to any provider. So why Porkbun? Well, my focus in this GoDaddy exit series of videos is to help you migrate to a platform that will save you money and not try to sell you extra stuff you don't need. Porkbun checks both of these boxes. All of their products, including domains, web hosting, and email hosting, are very affordable and could easily save you hundreds of dollars per year, depending on how much you're migrating. Porkbun was kind enough to sponsor this series, and when we came up with the idea, I knew they were the perfect provider to partner with. Porkbun's email hosting is already affordable at $24 per year per inbox, but they're offering Crailer Made viewers 50% off your first year with promo code 50OffBunMail, bringing the first year total to just $12. Considering GoDaddy's cheapest email hosting plan renews at $96 a year, I'd say the effort to move to Porkbun is well worth it. So with that being said, let's jump into the migration. To migrate your email from GoDaddy to Porkbun, start by logging into the Porkbun dashboard and clicking this email icon next to your desired domain. If you haven't already transferred your domain to Porkbun, I would recommend doing that first. It is possible to purchase email hosting without transferring your domain by clicking the Add External Domain button and linking your domain with the Porkbun dashboard, but if your goal is to ditch GoDaddy entirely, I think it makes sense to start with the domain migration. I have an entire tutorial you can check out if you need some help with this. Since the domain is already in my account, I'll proceed with clicking the email icon, and we're presented with two options. There's email hosting and email forwarding, but since I'm migrating an inbox, I want to proceed with email hosting, so I'll click Add Hosted Email Account. When the email hosting is added to your cart, don't forget to click the Add Coupon button and use promo code 50OffBunMail for 50% off the first year. Now you can scroll down and enter your billing details to complete the order. Next, click Manage Email and you'll see a new inbox in the Pending Setup area. Click Configure and enter your desired email address. Since you're migrating, you'll want to enter the same email address you currently use. If you have multiple users, you can repeat this process after to add additional inboxes. Enter a password and click Create Email Address. Once you do this, Porkbun's email hosting should be powering your email. The DNS records are automatically configured when the hosting is added. The only thing you'll want to do is click the Configure DMARC button to help improve email deliverability. Click OK, and it should take about 10 minutes for DMARC to be configured. While that's configuring, we can start migrating your inbox from GoDaddy to Porkbun. Unfortunately, there's no way to export your inbox from GoDaddy, so the best approach is to connect both accounts to an email client. Then, you can drag and drop mail in each folder between accounts. I'll use the Canary Mail app for this since it's free and available on both Mac and Windows. If you already have a preferred email client such as Apple Mail or Outlook, you can follow the same process in your email client of choice. Head to the Canary Mail website linked below and click Download. You'll need to choose the marketplace that corresponds with your operating system, so since I'm on Mac, I'll choose the macOS App Store. Once the application is installed, click Continue and progress through the setup wizard until you get to the Add Account screen. Click Other and enter your email address and password. This will be the password you created for your Porkbun email account. Then click the toggle to show Advanced, and for the incoming server, the username is just going to be your email address, and hostname is going to be imap.porkbun.com. Your port should be 993 and security should be set to SSL. Now for the outgoing server, the username is still going to be your email address, but this time the hostname is smtp.porkbun.com. The port should be 587, but security should be set to start TLS. Now you can scroll down and click Sign In. Next, enter your name, and I'll give the account a unique name so we can keep track of it when migrating the data. I'll just call this Custom New, and click Continue. Canary Mail is free to use, but they'll make you opt into a 7-day free trial of the Pro version. They do not require your credit card details, so you can continue using it for free after the trial ends. So I'll click try free for 7 days and I'll say not now and ask if I want to make this the default mail application. So now your new Porkbun inbox is linked with Canary Mail. But before we can add your old GoDaddy inbox, we need to change the email address since Canary Mail and other mail clients won't let you add the same email address twice. To do this, go to the GoDaddy dashboard and scroll down to Email and Office and click Manage All. Scroll down to Users and click Manage on your email address. Scroll down to Account Information and click Edit. Now, you want to make the username something unique. It can be whatever you want, maybe Hello Alt, and click Save. And it's very important on this screen that you click OK. For whatever reason, if you don't click OK, it doesn't save the changes. So I'll click OK. Then you can confirm the changes are made right here. It says updating your account. Now head back to Canary Mail and in the main menu, select Add Account. This time we'll pick Office 365 and enter the new email you just created in GoDaddy. I'll click Next. Then I'll enter my password and click Sign In. Then I'll enter my name. And this time I'll name the account Custom Old and click Continue. Both inboxes are accessible from the left sidebar, and you can click the arrow to the right of the account name to reveal the inbox, and you can also go to More to reveal all the folders. So what we want to do is move all the emails from the old inbox to the new inbox. I can do this by clicking the email on the top and scrolling down to the bottom of the inbox, holding Shift and clicking the bottom email. Then I can right click and say Move to Custom New, and click Inbox. Now, another way you can select all of the emails in bulk is by clicking this button at the top that says Bulk Cleaner and clicking Select All. And if you have thousands of emails in your inbox, you may want to do this in batches of a couple hundred at a time. But what's nice is since we're moving the emails, as they're moved from the old inbox to the new one, they are removed from the old inbox. So unlike copying, where you may not be sure if you already copied something and you don't want to accidentally copy it twice, but you also don't want to leave something behind, this system works well because if you've already moved it, it's out of the inbox. So you can do it in batches of 50 or 100 or 200 emails and slowly work through it till you get everything moved over. So just to give you an example, I'll select these two emails at the top of my inbox and say move to custom new inbox. You can see they were taken out of this inbox. And then if I go to my custom new inbox, I see the two emails that I just moved. This process could take a while depending on how many emails you're moving, and you'll also have to repeat this process for each folder. So if you've got stuff in folders beyond the inbox, you have to move those separately. Moving emails in the inbox is going to leave all those emails in your folders behind. So while you wait, if you're finding this video helpful, I would greatly appreciate it if you could hit that subscribe button and click the bell. It's free to subscribe and you'll be the first to know when I release new videos. After everything is moved over, I would highly recommend testing your new email. Try sending an email to another email address you have access to, maybe your personal email. Then reply from that email back to your custom email and make sure that you got the response. If everything is working as expected, you're ready to cancel your email hosting at GoDaddy. In my case, I'm not receiving emails as expected. They're still going to my old GoDaddy inbox, so let's see what's going on. The first step is to go to the Porkbun email hosting dashboard and scroll down. Start by clicking this Fix DNS button and click OK. This will make sure that the DNS records for Porkbun's email hosting are added to your domain. But in my case, I'm still not receiving emails. So let's go look at the DNS records and see what might be going on. I'm just going to go to the account dropdown and select Domain Management and scroll down to my domain and click DNS. Let me scroll down to the DNS records and see what's going on here. And immediately I see the problem. So these are the two MX records for Porkbun's email hosting. We have this MX record that is a holdout from GoDaddy. So that's why emails are still going to the old inbox. This MX record is here and it doesn't need to be. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this and click OK. And this auto discover CNAME is also what's going to cause some email clients to assume that your email is using Microsoft 365. So if you don't want to get that response anymore, and why would you? Because you have to link it with IMAP and SMTP. you can go ahead and delete the CNAME as well. After resolving the conflict with the MX records, my email address is working as expected. If you're still having trouble, you can reach out to Porkbun's amazing customer support. I'm also available to chat in my Discord server. It's free to join, and I help out as much as I can. You can also chat with other members of the community, so I'll have it linked below. When you're settled into your new inbox, don't forget to cancel your old email hosting at GoDaddy. Go to the GoDaddy dashboard and select your name in the top right corner, and click Renewals and Billing, and find your email subscription, and click the three dots, and click Turn Off Auto Renew. And you can select whatever reason you want. I'm just gonna say no longer want slash need, continue, no thanks, continue, and yes, cancel. And as long as this says cancels, you will not be charged when the email hosting comes up for renewal, and your email address will be automatically deleted once your hosting expires. So make sure all the data is migrated before that time. And that's it. You've successfully migrated your email away from GoDaddy. If you've got a website you also need to migrate away from GoDaddy, you can check out that video here.